Hello, dear students. How are you? Hope you're fine. Today we are going to start with a new letter in the Arabic language. Actually, this letter resembles so much the letter that we've taken it from around 1 month. First, let's start introducing the objectives. So you as students, you should know to know this letter with all its forms, short sounds and long sounds. Write this letter in a proper way and read words and sentences that contains this letter. Okay? Now, what is our letter about? Let's look, it's the letter Ghain. And if you see this letter, it resembles a lot the letter A, but the difference is that it has a point above, okay? What we're going to do now is that we have to know that this is the letter Ghain, and we pronounce it Gha, okay? Ghain, and we pronounce it Gha. Let's remember, how do we draw first the letter A before we put the point above it? We have three parts to draw the letter A. First, what do? We draw a small arch, like this. So first we draw a small arch, like this. I'm going to show you what are the first part. Draw a small arch. Then draw the number one like this, which is like this obliquely in Arabic, okay? And then we draw the stomach, the third part, which is like the letter C. Let's apply it. Draw a small arch. Then draw the number one oblique. Okay. Then please draw what now? The letter, the stomach of the letter C. Draw the stomach of the letter C. Notice here, guys, this side at the beginning of the stomach is smaller than this side, and it should be. Okay, I started with an arch. I've drawn the number one like this. I've drawn the letter C. I've gone like this. Okay, and what do I put now? The point. If you look at the head of the letter gha and the stomach, they should be making a straight line in order to make sure that you are writing it correctly. Okay? So again, what do? I draw a small arch. Okay? I go down obliquely like the letter gha. Okay? It's not a little bit. We put the point here. And now, draw the stomach of the letter, what? Go a little bit like this and make it. Notice here, the side is smaller than the side. And if I see it's making a straight line over here, okay? So this is the letter Gha. This is the letter Gha. Now let's learn or let's start with the forms of letter Gha. So let's see how many forms of letter Gha do we have, and let's read the words. Let's start with this. Where's the letter Gha in this word? Beginning, middle, or end? It's at the end. Is it separated or connected? Separated. Because it's preceded by Ra, and as we know, Ra has two forms only. Okay? So this letter Gha is separated at the end. So this is the first form of the letter Gha that comes at the end and is the separated form. Now, how do we draw it again? Let's draw it here. We draw an arch. Then number one, like this. Then the stomach of the letter. What of the letter C? And we put the line, don't forget to put the line. This is the letter Gha. Arch, number one oblique, stomach of the letter C, this side is smaller than this side, and the head is making a straight line with the stomach, okay? This is the letter Gha. So what, let's read. What is the girl doing here? She is emptying the trash from the box. This is a box and it contains trash. She is emptying the trash from this box and throwing it where in the basket. Let's read this word. What does empty something from the box means? To, this is ta. Tuf, this is fa, okay? Tuf, ri, ru. Tuf, ri, ru. Okay, so emptying is tufrigo. Let's now go to another form. What do you see here? You see a cloud, okay? You see a cloud. What does cloud mean in Arabic? First, let's look, where is the letter gha? Beginning, middle, or end? Here's the letter gha. Okay? Here is the letter gha. Type. Let's see, guys. How do we draw the letter gha over here? Okay? The letter gha over here. So the letter gha is at the beginning here. Let's read it. Ghay, because yeh. Ghay. Ma-ton. So it's ghaimaton, okay? Ghaimaton. Let's see how do we draw the letter gha over here. I'm making a straight line. So this letter gha is part of the letter ghather. Yani as if you're taking this point, guys. What do we do? What do we do? A little bit up, okay? Just an arch, please. Then, number one. Then an oblique number one, like this. Okay? Clear? And we put the point. I'm going to repeat. Let's see. Yeah. It's very easy. It's not hard at all. Please, a little bit above the line. Then number one, then an oblique number one. And notice from this side, what you are leaving a space, okay? I'm going to repeat again so you can see it more properly. Okay, line. A little bit, number one. Okay, arch, then number one, then an oblique, what? Number one in Arabic. Okay, again and again. Yeah, we've made a mistake here. Please make sure the gha here, it's not that much big, it's small, okay? Make it a little bit small. Yani for example, 2 points. Okay. Then make the number one like this. Then take the gha like this, okay? So here, an arch, then down number one, then number one by leaving a space like this, okay? As if this is the line, guys, and you see a space here, okay? So, arch, actually a small arch, number one like this. Then a number one, which is oblique, make it a little bit oblique. But actually, this number one should be a little bit, for example, this is the line, this side should be a little bit above the line, okay? I'll repeat again. Number one, like this. Number one, which is down, okay? This is the letter G, okay? This is the letter G, which is, I've drawn an arc, small arch, okay? Then I've go down an oblique number one like this, because the number one is like this in Arabic. Then I'll draw another oblique number one, but you have in this side to be a little bit above the line. See here? This is number one in Arabic, but it's oblique. But from this side, you should be a little bit above the line, okay? And I put the point. This is the letter غ, okay? Let's see the letter غ. So غي ماتون and تفرغ. Let's write here the letter غ in order to make the four forms here. So what did we say? The arch. Should we say we said the arch? Then number one. Then the oblique number. One. Yeah. Now, let's draw, or let's see how is the letter G written in the middle. What do we see here? A magnet. Let's read it. Where is the letter G? Here is the letter G, because it's connected to two letters. Mag. Magnetis. Magnetis. What is the letter G here? It's in the middle. How do we draw this letter G? Guys, as if you're walking a straight line, okay? Then you are jumping like that. Then you are going down, okay? Then you are going like this and drawing the letter G. Again, let's draw it here. You are walking, then jump suddenly, then going down, then going down like this. This is the letter غ in the middle, okay? So we have غي ماتون, مغ ناطيس in the middle غ like this, and we have تفرغ the غ is like this. Now, what do we see here? A glue, okay? A glue. What do you mean by glue? Let's see. What's this letter? سا, check. سو. M-ghu, sum-gh. طيب, this, where is the letter gha here? It's at the end. It's separated or connected? Separated because it's preceded by ma. So we have two forms at the end, one separated and one connected. Let's see how do we draw the gha at the end. Please, it's the same beginning like the middle. You are walking, then you jump, then you go down, then you have to make it like this. But while you're making it like this, you have to make the letter C, okay? So I walked, I jump, I go down, and then I make the letter C. Again, this, the head and the hand should be at the same line, okay? This is as a beginning. And here, at the end, it should be short. It's not like the letter A long here, okay? So it should be short, as we said. And it should, between this line and this line, it should make at least 5 points like the letter A. 1, 2, 3, 4. So it's it should make the shape of letter A, okay? So let's write it here. I'm walking. I will jump. I will go down. Then I will go down. Then I will make the letter C. Like this, okay? So how many forms of letter غ do we have? We have four forms. One at the beginning, two in the middle, and three. One is separated at the end, and one is connected at the end. So we have four forms. Let's read them. So غي ماتون is cloud. مغناطيس is magnet. سمغ is glue, and تفرغ is to empty. So these are the forms of letter غ. Let's continue. Let's read this sentence. What do you see in this sentence? Oh, a girl is drawing a picture. What did she draw? A cloud. A girl is drawing a cloud and a sun also. Okay, let's read. Let's read. So this is ta, short sound. Then re, ter. Then su, then mu. Tersumu, okay? Because we started with ta, of course, we're talking about a girl who's drawing, okay? Tersumu, who? Let's see who's tersumu. Tersumu, which means a draw. Who's drawing? Ra. So, ra, da, tersumu. Ra, da. What is she drawing? A cloud. We took it. Ghay, mah. Please, this ta marbuta, as if it's ta, even if it's ta, we don't pronounce it. We pronounce it like ha at the end because there is a punctuation mark. So, tarsumu ghada ghayma. As if you're saying ghayma. Ghayma. So, that when you are stopping and having a punctuation mark, the ta marbuta is pronounced tarsumu ghada ghayma, which means that ghada is drawing what? A cloud. Okay? Now, these are the forms of the letter gha. Gha at the beginning. Gha in the middle. Gha at the end separated. And gha at the end what? Connected. Is it clear? Now let's apply a small exercise on the forms of letter gha. Okay? Actually, let's start with this. Here, where is the letter gha? Should be beginning, middle, or end? In middle. How do we draw it in the middle? Yeah, let's start. I walk, then I jump, then I go down, then like this. This is the letter gha, and I put the point. Okay? What did I do? I'm walking, I jump, I go down, I go like this. And I put, this is hasn't to be big like this. Don't please make it big. It's wrong, okay? Make this here a little bit small. Okay. Here, let's go to the letter gha here. Is it beginning, middle, or end? End. Okay, separated or connected? Separated. So we should choose which one, because it's preceded by ra. Ra has two forms and cannot be connected to the letter after it. So what do? I am drawing an arch right now. The letter gha, the head is above the line and the stomach is below the line. Then draw the oblique or the number one in Arabic, and then please start drawing now the what? The stomach. And as we said, we put the point here. So this side is smaller than this side. And as you saw, the head will make a straight line with the stomach. Okay. Now let's see the letter gha here. Here it's in the middle. Do we choose this form, guys? Well, it's preceded by what? By ra. Look here, ra cannot be connected to the letter after it. So we choose the form of the letter gha that is at the beginning. This cannot be applied here. So what do we do? What do we do? We draw what? An arch. Then number one like this. Then the oblique. So yarghab, okay? So here also in this word, how is the letter drawn? How is it drawn? Like this. Because the letter at the beginning is like this. What do? Draw an arch, go down like number one, and then what do? Draw the number one that is oblique. Okay, this is the gha at the beginning. Okay, so, and if you want, if we didn't take here an example on the end, what do to draw it at the end? Let's assume this is the line. Okay, this is the line. You are walking, you are going up, jumping, then going down, then like this. So this, the head has to be above the line and continue like drawing the letter C. But as you see here, this side is small from here. Don't make it a big, and put the point. And the stomach and the head are making a straight line, okay? This is regarding the forms, guys. Let's continue. Now, after we finish from the forms, we go to what usually the short sounds. Yeah? Okay. What do you see here? A cloud. Let's read it because we've read it many times. غيمةٌ. غيمةٌ. Okay? So here, what's the short sound here? غ. غ. غ with فتحة. What do you see here? A bedroom. Okay, let's read it. Hey, this is غ, but how do we read it? Do we read it غ? It's غو. غرفةٌ. Or you can say غرفة. If you want to say it غرفة and it's silent, you have to make it غرفة. يعني at the end, غرفة. Okay? So, غيمةٌ غرفة. So now we have غ with فتحة, غو with ضم. Okay? Continue. Here, what do we have? This is a cover of a book, the cover of the book, okay? When you open the book, there is a cover of the book. This is a cover of a photo or cover of a book, whatever. Let's read it. Okay, watch this. غابت, it's down كسرة غي. يلا, watch this. لا, plus a غلافون, because this is فا. So غي, لا plus a لا. Phone. So غلافٌ, which is the cover of a book. So now we have غ, غو, غي. يلا, let's read. Where's the letter غ? It's in the middle. غ. Now غ, غو, غي, غ. يلا, ما, مغ, مغ والسكون. مغ, سا, له. Either you say مغسلة, if you want to make it silent. مغسلة or مغسلةٌ. Okay? Look at the مغسلةٌ when you wash your hands. This is the مغسلة. So غلاف. مغسلة. Now, let's read. Where is غادة? غادة is in the bedroom. She is fixing her bed after she woke up. So غادة is in her bedroom. يلا, let's read. غا. Here we don't have any short sound. We have غا plus أ. If you have غا plus أ, غا. Then, دا غادة or غادة غادة. Then we have فا and يا. فا and يا as a long sound. في, we go down. Everything فا, a letter with يا, make it a long sound. غادة في. So غادة في يعني غادة in. Where is غادة? In her room. Okay, so غر, we read it. غر فا تي. Watch this. Ha, this is ha. Okay, this is ha in the middle, guys. Like the vibration of the wave, okay? غرفاتي, ha, this is ha. And we have a long sound with a, because we have, if we have a letter and after it an a, you are going up. If you have a letter after it, ya, you are going down. So, غادة في غرفتي ha. So, this is ha, and you add a to make it ha, okay? This ha goes to what? Her. So غرفة is room only, and ها is her room. So غادة is in her room. غادة is the name of the girl. في is in. غرفة is room, and ها is her room. So غادة في غرفتها. So what are the short sounds of letter غا, غا, غو, غي, غ. Whatever form you choose, you can choose it, okay? Let's read now. We are going to start with the long sounds of the letter غ. Yeah. What do you see here? We are going to come down. We have غ and أ. Do you have any short sounds? No. So it's غ, ب, تون. Either you say غ, ب, تون if you want to pronounce it. And if you want to make it this silent, غ, ب, غ, ب. Okay? مش غابت, غابة. So غابة, this is the long sound. Let's see how do we draw it. The same, at the beginning. Huh? Going down, then a little bit up. Then we draw the letter A and we put the point, okay? Now, what is this boy doing? He's diving in the water, okay? This is غا. Where is the long sound of غا? Hey, this is غا, and after it وا. So غا and after it وا, I move to the front usually. غو, 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 غو because I'm moving to the front but in a long sound. Let's read it. يغوصو يعني he's diving. Okay, he's diving inside the water. Maybe he wants to catch fishes, whatever. يغوصو. Look how do we draw it. The letter وا has to lay down on the line, so the letter غا should be up a little bit. I draw the line, I'm walking, I'm jumping, then going down, then like this, okay? And then I draw the letter wa. Also, I can choose this form at the beginning and I draw it here, but I have to make it a little bit up. So غا, غابة, غو, يغوصو, okay? Now let's see the third, the last one. What is this? We have slices of bread. Yes, we have slices of bread. Yalla, let's read. Where is غا? Okay, does it have a short sound? No, and there is no short sound. What comes after it? Yeah. So غا plus يا, what does it make? غي, يعني I'm moving down. غي. Okay, let's draw it. If you want, let's choose this. I'm drawing an arc now. Going down. And then غا, then غي, okay. را غي فون. Either رغيفون or if you want to make it silent, رغيف. رغيف is the slices. These are the slices. Okay. رغيف, which is bread. Okay. يعني one. This is the whole bread. This is one. One slices of bread, okay? Let's read this sentence. أرسمو. What do you mean by أرسمو? I am drawing. What am I am drawing? What am I drawing? غابتا. غابتا. Here I don't say غابة because it's not at the end. غابتا. It has to be pronounced. غابتا, which is a forest. صنوبر. So أرسم غابة صنوبر. Again, أرسم غابة صنوبر. What do you mean by أرسم غابة صنوبر? Let's see. أرسم is I'm drawing. I am drawing. غابة is forest. Okay. غابة is forest. And the last one is صنوبر. What do you mean by صنوبر? صنوبر. Pine tree. So she, he is drawing a forest that contains pine trees. So أرسم غابة صنوبر. Okay. So guys, these are the long sounds of letter غا, غا, غو, غي, غي. So we have two forms. This غي, the ya in the middle, and this غي, the ya at the end, okay? By this, guys, we finished our